It's up to just the last few years, really. I mean, we really thought that all of space weather was just driven by the sun. These solar flares, the radiation, these coronal mass ejections, and the plasma shooting out and creating the geomagnetic storms. But just over the last few years, really it's only in the last 5 years, that we've really realized that there's another branch of space weather that isn't coming from the sun, well, not from the variability of the sun, is actually coming from the weather systems down in the troposphere, the storm systems, the middle atmosphere dynamics. A lot of that energy is propagating up to the ionosphere and the thermosphere, where a lot of the space weather is occurring. So we're starting to see space weather effects when the sun is quite calm. So now we have to consider this fourth branch of space weather, as well as the flares and these coronal mass ejections and the energetic particles. We've also got this connection with the terrestrial weather, the space weather and terrestrial weather being very much connected. If we've got this connection now between terrestrial weather and space weather, we think, well, how can we forecast that? So we thought, well, you need the physical model. So we had to have a model that actually extended not just for the regular weather. We had to have a model that went all the way up to 600 kilometers that included all of these ionospheric effects in responding to the terrestrial weather. So we got together with the CIRES scientists, got together with our NOAA partners, both in SWPSI, in the Space Weather Prediction Center, and the NOAA lab on the East Coast, the Environmental Modeling Center. And together we extended their operational weather forecast model that they use for the weather forecast model in the US. It's called the Global Forecast System model. That normally went up to 60 kilometers, so a small height really, but now we're taking that up to 600 kilometers, so we're looking at a tenfold increase in the height of the atmosphere that we're trying to simulate. So we're now able to predict sort of the ionospheric impacts of some of these lower atmospheric events maybe a week ahead. So it's a whole new paradigm really that we're looking at with when we have these types of whole atmosphere models. It's really quite an exciting time to be in.